algebra. So if you're still working on getting the greatest common factor and you're struggling with it a little bit, there's two things that we need to point out that are going to be crucial in your success. And one is your multiplication skills. And the second is your organization. Okay, so I'm going to, if you're super strong in your multiplication skills, then you may not need to do all the things I'm about to do, but I'm just going to lay out a process that would help everybody from whether you're the highest or you're still struggling with this. Okay, so this is going to be, again, two things. We're going to deal with greatest common factor of monomials in relationship to our multiplication skills and our organization. Okay? So let's look at some examples. Let's just work through a bunch here. Okay. So the first thing that we're going to do here is we're going to find the greatest common factor. And we're going to be greatest common factor between 10b and 8b. So to start this process off, what you want to do is you want to take these two things and separate them. And what we want to do initially is think about, well, what are the factors of 10? And how are you going to get 10? 1 times 10, that's 10. 2 times 5. And we want to list these from least to greatest. So I'm going to say that's 1, 2, 5, 10. And we have a single B in there. So you can look at that. That's 1 times 10. There's 10. 2 times 5, that's 10. Those are the numbers that are going to get you to a 10, okay? And we do the same thing with 8B. How are you going to get 8? 1 times 8, 2 times 4. Let's write those in least to greatest. And there they are, 1 times 8, 2 times 4, and there is that single B. So all we're looking for now to determine what the greatest common factor is, what is the greatest number they share? Well, it's right there. So that's part of the answer. And what's the greatest number of variables? Well, there's only one B that's shared amongst them both. So it's 2B. Okay? Again, on the next one, just pause it, try it without me, then play it through. So here we go, 8x, I'm sorry, 4x and 8x. So let's separate those two and write out their components here. So how are we going to get a 4? 1 times 4, 2 times 2, so let's write those least to greatest. 1, 2, 4. And x. How are we going to get 8? 1 times 8, 2 times 4, 1, 2, 4, and 8. And of course, it also has 1x here. And again, all we're looking for is the greatest number that is a factor for both and the greatest number of exponents that they share. Well, they share a 2. Oh, my bad. I apologize. They share a 4, and they share an x. So they both have a 4, it's the greatest number, and the greatest number of x's is one single x. So it's 4x. Okay? Let's keep working them. 15. Q to the third and 5q squared. So let's separate these two. Go ahead and write their factors. How are we going to get a 5? 5 is a prime number. It's only 1 times 5. So we've got a 1. We've got a 5. We've got two q's here. We've got a q and a q. So there's the numbers. There's the way to get 5. 1 times 5, and there's two q's. How are we going to get 15? 1 times 15, 3 times 5. So we've got a 1, a 3, a 5, and a 15. And I've got three of these. 1, 2, 3. And again, always double check your numbers. How am I getting a 5? 1 times 5. How am I getting a 15? 1 times 15, 3 times 5. And we'll look for the greatest number they share. That's right here. And the greatest number of variables they share. This one has 2, so we can only include 2 down here. So it's 5 squared. And there is the greatest common factor between these two monomials, 5q squared. Okay? So let's look at this one. 2 that has no variable and 6z squared. So let's separate those two. Only way to get a 2 is 1 times 2. That's the only even prime number. So there's 1 and a 2. There are no variables, so we don't have to worry about it. Here we've got 6. 1 times 6 and 2 times 3. So let's put those in order. And there's 2 z's. So what is the greatest number they share? Well, it's the 2. And what's the greatest number of variables they share? Well, there aren't any. So the greatest common factor is just a 2. It can't be 2z. There are no z's in the first one. Okay? That would have been an easy one to miss. So now we've got 3 of them. Well, it doesn't matter. We could have 2, 3, 5. It doesn't matter. We're going to just take these and separate these. So let's do that again. And do the same thing. How are we going to get a 9? 1 times 9 and 3 times 3, putting those least to greatest, is right there. Now, we don't need to write the 3 twice because the 3 is a 3. And we've got 4 y's. 1, 2, 3, here, how am I going to get a 12? And I'll just do this over here in case you want to see at least what I'm talking about verbally here. You know, that's kind of what you're thinking about. 1 times 12, 2 times 6, 3 times 4, and then you can see it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, and 12. These are the numbers I'm going to write here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, and 12, because that's how we would get 12, right? Those are all 12. And I got 3 y's. 1, 2, 3. And now we're going to get a 3. Well, that's a prime number, so the only way to get a 3 is 1 times 3. And there's 3 y's. 1, 2, 3. What is the greatest number that's in this list, and this list? Now, it can't be a 9 because this one doesn't have it. This one doesn't have it. You can almost cross that out. This one has a 3, a 3, and a 3. So there it is. It's right there. There's the greatest number they all three have. So we know the greatest common factor has to include the 3. And this one has 1, 2, 3 variables, 1, 2, 3 variables, 1, 2, 3 variables. So there's the variables that we have to include, 3 of them. Three y cubed. That is the greatest common factor, these three polynomials. Okay? So some people were calling me and emailing me about they were getting up into the 40 and 50 percentile, but then they were messing up a little bit. And oftentimes it's probably because this is about the time the assignment started to have addition and subtraction involved. But it doesn't matter, okay? We have 2 pieces of information. We can do the same thing here. We can just separate these two and do the same thing. And I'll kind of do this one just a little bit more elaborate. This is 1 times 9. 3 times 3. So you can see your numbers, 1, 3, and 9. 1, 3, and 9. 2 z's. Z times z. How do you get 15? 1 times 15. 2 doesn't go in there. 3 does. 3 times 5. And that's it. 1, 3, 5, and 15. And there's 1 z there. And what's the greatest number? And the greatest number of variables. So you can look at the list going, well, they share a 3.
That's the greatest number. They didn't have a 5. This one didn't have a 9. This one didn't have a 5. This one didn't have a 15. You can cross those out if you want to. Greatest number is a 3, so that has to be included. And this one only has one z, so we're only going to count a single z variable. And there's the greatest common factor between those two monomials. Okay? And I believe this is the last example. This one has 3 components. Let's separate those and do the same thing. Let's just be a good little math teacher here and show my work for 20. How do you get 20? 1 times 20, 2 times 10, 3 doesn't go in there, 4 times 5. And you can see 1, 2, 4, 5, 10, and 20 should be our numbers. 1, 2, 4, 5, 10, and 20. And how many variables? Well, we've got 2 of these, 2 b's. Now we're going to get 16. 16 would be 1 times 16, 2 times 8, 3 doesn't work, 4 times 4, and you can see 1, 2, 4, 8, and 16 are our numbers. 1, 2, 4, 8, and 16, and this has a single b. Are we going to get 13? Well, that's 1 times 13. 1 and a 13. Has no variables. I don't need to write it. Again, the greatest common factor has to be a number they all share and the variables they all have. So in this particular instance, really easy problem to miss. The 1 is the greatest number they share. There are no b's here, so we can't count it. So the greatest common factor is 1. And if we're thinking about it, which is the next assignment, we're finding the greatest common factor because ultimately, if we were to reduce this, we would be thinking about what can I divide them all by evenly. In this particular instance, the only thing you could divide them evenly by is a 1. Okay? So hopefully that helps. Good luck.